Hi, everybody. Welcome. Let me just see. Okay. Hi, Gail. Hi, Barbara.
Hi, Billy.
Hi, Eric. Carrie
How's
Ann,
everybody?
hello. Oh, hi, Mary. We'll call you Mark for now. See, Julie's connected, and Terry and Chris. Hello, hello. How's everybody doing? Doing good?
Doing well. Good,
Good.
thanks.
Good. I know some people are joining from different areas. If you are not in Arizona currently, raise your hand. Do you know how to use the raise hand icon? Oh, quite a few of you. Very exciting. So where are people joining from? And you can unmute or you can put it in the chat, whatever works best for you. I have to see where my chat even is. Barbara,
Oh, I'm
where are
from
you joining?
Chicago.
Oh, Gail, you're in Chicago? Okay.
Yeah. I'm in Iowa.
Chris is in Iowa currently. Washington, Carrie Ann. Okay.
Chicago.
Okay. So many Illinois
Right?
women.
Yeah, we call Scottsdale are very southwest suburb.
The suburb, the
That's
southwest Chicago suburb. Yes.
awesome. Yeah.
Great, great, great. Where else? Anybody else joining from any place other than Arizona? No. Okay. Well, we're glad for all of the ones who are in Arizona. We're starting to cool off. Like low
Finally.
hundreds, finally, for sure. It was a hot one this summer. Started out a little bit mild as we got through June. Eric and I were like, huh, this isn't too bad. We should have never said anything, and we apologize that we jinxed. We jinxed July. July and August and September, but yeah, starting to cool down, so that's good. All right. So let me go ahead and I'm going to share my screen and get some stuff up on here. And I should have created a slide that showed had us introduce ourselves. So I guess we'll have to just do that on our own, Eric. I didn't even think about that, but here we are. So I guess we'll start with some introductions. Eric, I'll let you go ahead and introduce yourself, and then I'll introduce myself.
Okay. Hi, everybody. My name is Eric Solberg. Obviously, Julie's my wife. I'm a professional golf coach. I've been coaching for, I started my early 20s and I've crossed over the 50 mark. So I've been doing it a long time. Started this league. It's something I've wanted to do for a long time, for women to get more women involved in the league or into golf, I should say. And I thought, just because I would see him come to me in lessons and I would hear stories about just not feeling comfortable out there and just other stuff like that. So I thought about starting a league would be good to get a bunch of women playing together so they could get more comfortable playing together and then branch out and maybe learn the rules that way. And just a place also for people just to, make friends when we come together and play golf. I don't think it should be dominated by men. So that's been going on for a little while now. then Julie really has been just awesome of kind of taking the reins of this league and just doing a great job with it. And so it's fun just watching it, and it's fun kind of seeing it grow and just kind of seeing what it evolves into. So that's my quick little, that's me.
Yeah, thank you. So I'm Julie Schulberg, and like several members of our league, I still consider myself a beginner to golf. So I really didn't start playing until we started the league. Eric and I have been married for 7 years, and it's something, or six years. I keep jumping ahead another year. Like we're in our seventh year of marriage. We'll say it that way. And I wasn't a golfer, and it just never seemed like something that I was super interested in doing. Cause like, how fun can it be to hit a little ball around grass to get it in a hole? And then I tried, and I was like, this is the most frustrating thing ever, and it's amazing. And so when we moved to the area, and Eric had, it was just kind of this culmination. There was a woman in a Facebook group who had asked, who would be interested in a league that was, inclusive of beginners, kind of a safe space for anybody to participate. And since we were moving, I was like, hey, I'd like to get to know some people. So yeah, I would love to be part of that league. And my husband, happens to be a golf pro. So if you want help organizing, I'm sure that he would be able to give you some help and some tips and pointers. And so we met with her, and shortly after our first meeting, she was like, this is too much. I can't do it right now. And so we took it over, because it had already been like announced that we were going to be doing it. And it was something that Eric had been wanting to do. So we were like, let's do it. So we moved forward. And so then I have really enjoyed it. Like the women that I've met, getting out and playing and seeing the improvement that I've had through a combination of having to be out there on my own and gaining confidence that way. And then working with Eric as well. It's been good to see just kind of my slow progression. So yeah, it's something that I just enjoy doing. And I kind of joke around that organization is my superpower. So I like to organize things. I like to put things in Excel spreadsheets, which sounds crazy to a lot of people, but that's just who I am. So I feel like this was just kind of meant to be with how stars aligned, and has just been a really good way to get involved and meet a lot of people. So for the agenda today, we're going to cover three main things. So we're going to talk about the benefits that the league provides. We're going to talk about expectations of the league. And then we're going to dive a little bit into some golf etiquette, kind of some common questions that we get asked, and just kind of gaps that we've noticed as we've been working with golfers. And then we'll have time at the end for questions. So feel free to put questions in the chat if you don't want to lose a question. But I think for the most part, we'll kind of pause questions until we get to the end, just to kind of get things moving and see if your question gets answered as we move through material. So league benefits. So we really do offer 9 whole rounds. That's what the first members really had said that they were interested in. So a full round of golf can take 4.5-5 hours. So doing nine holes, which is about 2 to 2 hours to 2 hours and 15 minutes, seems a little more bite-sized for people to do. And so that's what we're offering right now. It may be something that we expand. I feel like we've been getting more requests for 18 hole rounds. So we're going to look and see whether that's something that would be sustainable with the interest that may be within the league members and potential league members. So look for that possibly coming. But every round does include cart fee and a small bucket of range balls to warm up ahead of time. And so it is something that it is kind of the full package. So we do play at McCormick Ranch Golf Club. And that's something that we're kind of looking to expand. And we'll talk about that on the next page about some additional benefits that we're looking at and we're going to be providing. After each round, we do organize dinner and drinks when there's more than four RSVPs. So if it's four people or less, we let you guys decide if you where you want to go and kind of figure that out. But once it's over four, then we do make reservations at restaurants that are somewhat close by to the course, because the restaurant at the course is closed by the time we're done with our rounds. So we look for other places to go and meet. And it's just a fun way to socialize after the round, because you don't get to meet everybody or spend a lot of time chatting and getting to know others. So just a little more of a social engagement there. The next one I'm excited about. So previously we offered 10% off individual lessons with Eric. So he offers like 1, 2, and 3 hour lessons. And we increase that this year to 20%. So 20% off those lessons if you want to schedule something with him to work on your golf game. Then we are offering some discounts on 1.5 hour women's golf clinics. And that's something that you'll be getting like early bird access to registration. And through that early bird registration, you get the early bird discount. So members get that, and then it'll be opened up to the public after a certain date. So we're finalizing dates and pricing and things for that. So look for information on that, that will be coming soon. And then we'll be offering additional webinars over different content, different concepts, different topics about golf. So those will just be free half hour for you to come and kind of potentially pick Eric's brain about things as he shares them. So I feel like he's one of the main benefits, and he's actually on this next page. But really having a golf pro at your disposal to be able to ask questions about, I kind of jumped the gun because I put that at the last benefit, but we'll, I guess, go from the bottom up. So
I think, Julie, it'd be cool to get ideas for, I think, webinars too, of topics that want covered. So feel free to let us know if you want me to cover something in a webinar, and we'll see if we fit it in with something.
Yeah. And that leads us to the next one, our Facebook group, which a lot of you probably are already a part of, but we do have a Facebook group where we'll be soliciting ideas. So topics that you want covered in webinars. As we kind of look at whether we want to include 18 whole rounds, getting feedback from our members. And so we do ask as we put out polls to respond to those, because if we don't get your input, I know some people are like, it's just me, it's just one person, I'm happy with whatever. But we want to hear from you. We want to hear what you want, so that we make sure that we're offering the value and things that you're looking for, and the skills that you're looking to gain through the league as a golfer. We are working on some preferred partners that I'm really excited about, but I don't want to announce anything until they are finalized. So that is more information to be coming soon. So through preferred partners, having some discounts to some local things, offering events that will be just for league members. So I am really excited about that. And then another thing is our Scottsdale Duos Golf League that we're starting. So I've heard from several different people in the league and outside of the league, couples who have been looking for other couples that they want to play golf with. And it can kind of be a little bit tricky to find where there's a husband and a wife or partners or whatever that that golf together, because sometimes one golfs, the other doesn't, or they just don't golf well together. And so we feel like there is this missing niche of people who like to play golf together and want to be partners in golf, And so we're creating this duos golf league to play at various spots throughout, like different courses throughout the Scottsdale area. We're going to start once a month and offer events on Saturdays, like Saturday afternoons. And so the first one is going to be at McCormick Ranch. We're getting all of the details, and that'll be announced soon so people can start registering, because it's coming up in October. But I'm really, really excited about that. So look for more information about that. And I'll be sending out an email to all of you as well that's going to have links to various things that will have information. And we'll continue to share information as it comes available. Let me make sure if there's anything else I wanted to touch on for benefits. I think that is it. Can you think of anything else to add, Eric, for any of those?
No.
Mm-mm. Okay. So then our league expectations. So just some information to keep in mind. So registration for our events, the deadline is 3 days prior to each event. And that's for us to give numbers to the course for the deadline that they have, for them to then solidify the tee times and to charge us, like charge for the tee times. And so there are no refunds that are given after that deadline. So the third item is about letting me know if you're unable to make it after that deadline. If you can text me to let me know that you're not able to come, that's typically the best way for me to kind of keep things straight so it doesn't get lost in my email inbox. And will allow me to make adjustments to pairings and things. And if it is after that deadline and you're wanting to find a replacement, you're welcome to post within the Facebook group to see if there's anybody who maybe wasn't sure if they would be available, and they do have that availability. So you can reach out and kind of work out with them how to get payment from them, for them to take your spot. And then you just need to text me and let me know who's taking the place, so that we can make sure we know about it and we can let the course know about it. Pairing requests. So sometimes people want to make sure that they're playing with the same people, and understand friendships are great and are important. And that's part of why we have the league. And part of why we have the league is also for everybody to get to know each other. So kind of mixing and mingling. We also do make pairs based on a number of different things. So we make pairings with intention. So typically we don't allow pairing requests unless somebody's like bringing a guest or something like that, that they want to make sure that they're playing with, because they aren't part of the league. It's kind of a one-time thing. So in general, we would just ask to be open to play with various people within the league. Like it says on the last one, being supportive of one another. I feel like in general, that's how it has been. I feel like the caliber of women that join our league are supportive of one another. I've never seen anybody be critical or condescending in terms of people playing and all of those things. So I feel like it is just a great caliber of woman that joins our league. Please arrive to events early. I typically ask for you to arrive about 15 minutes before the first tee time, because again, sometimes we do need to make adjustments to tee times depending upon who has to cancel and that type of a thing. So if you're able to arrive early, that gives us time to make adjustments as needed. Anything to add to any of those expectations, Eric?
No, you covered it good.
Okay. So golf etiquette, this is where I'm going to let Eric take over a little bit more. I guess I'll just start with the first one, to assume the best of intentions, that we want to help one another understand golf etiquette. So if somebody points something out, take it as the best of intention. This isn't a place where we want people to feel like they're being attacked. It's it's meant to help us get better, to make sure that we're keeping pace of play and doing the things that we need to take care of the golf course and just being mindful golfers. And then what would you add to that, Eric, in terms of best intentions?
It doesn't mean that you have to be out there, you know, accepting, I guess, people giving you advice about what you're doing. That I don't think that's at all. I think it's there's two main things leading into this that we have to do for the course. One of them is treat the course well, obviously, by just understanding. And there's a lot of beginners out there just don't know what to do. And the other is keeping up pace, and which I'll get into too. And to me, those are the two main things. And there are two things I think any golfer can do, whether you play golf or not, with a little bit of instruction. And I'll get into kind of how we can do that. So, like, ready golf, what is ready golf? As long as somebody is not right in front of you, ready golf means hit the ball. So when you get over to your golf ball and someone's on the right side of the fairway, let's say you're on the left, you just get up and hit. So it also means this is what we've noticed over the years, is that when somebody else is doing something else, you prepare to get ready for your shot. So you're already starting to look at maybe yardage. You're already doing whatever you need to do behind the scenes bit to get ready for it. I don't think this is listed here, but what, or I don't know if it's going to be on the next page, but this is what I said. Anybody can play golf in this league, or I think anywhere in any league, anywhere, or golf in general. If you take, let's just say you have a par four out there. If you take six shots on a par five or on a par four, or six or seven on a par five, I think you can say two over every time, then you're going to keep up with anybody no matter what. And I don't care if you hit those, if you miss the ball twice, you hit your third one 3 feet, you're still only taking six shots on a par four, the same as somebody else would, and then you pick your ball up and move on. So typically, if you maybe have a really bad tee shot, you hit it off the toe, it goes 12 feet or something, you want to hit another, or you go hit it, and it goes 20 feet, you're like, oh, it's bad. Pick it up, move it forward, and hit it from wherever you want to hit it, from 30 yards out. The whole goal is just keeping moving along if you don't have that ability yet to just hit that well. And so it's something that people would really, like if I went out and played, I would respect the heck out of the person if that's what they were doing. To keep up pace. So just always think in your mind, I have the ability to take two shots over, you know, whatever the par is. And it doesn't matter how good your shots are, you're still going to keep up no matter what. So anybody should be able to play this game and not cause a slowdown on the course. And we also do a lot of, when we mix groups up together, we'll do, for groups that are beginners and want to do it, we'll do scrambles. So that way everybody's playing from the same place. You'll take the best shot, and wherever the best tee shot is, you'll all go from there. And that'll help speed things along too. And I just know this from the years of hearing people tell me about just what causes pressure and stuff. And one of them is keeping pace, but you will have no problem if you always keep that in the back of your mind, how many shots that you can you take. And I thought this is always a funny thing too, because it's always assumed, you hear out there that women are slow golfers. Well, they've done this massive study, and guess who's faster at golf, men or women? Women in general. So it's just really crazy. That's just this assumption made by certain people that I've always disagreed with. But the problem is it puts pressure, I think, on certain people to feel like they have to go faster when you really don't. Another way to think of it is also keeping up with the group in front of you. But that is only, you know, if the group in front of you is going really slow, then, you know, that group in front of you needs, it doesn't mean you're doing good pace if they're slow too. It comes out to about 15 minutes a hole is what you should do. And I think just, you know, if you're new, or that's where you can learn golf cart, if going into golf cart etiquette, it's learning. I know, I remember when I taught Julie, like out on the course, like what to do with the cart, like learning where to put the cart, and that's stuff. So you don't have to run back 60 yards to go get it, you know, stuff like that. And that's something we'll just learn over time and talk more about. And I'll be out there, Julie will be out there trying to help with those kind of things too. You know, if you're new, trying to learn how to do that. And if you are a newer, we always try to put somebody in the group that maybe knows that stuff. And that's what I think we mean, assume the best intentions. If somebody says, is you know, plays golf quite often and knows, you know, where, you know, drive the cart all the way up to the green and walk back 20 yards with your putter and your wedges, and they say that to you, that's being helpful. Or, you know, if you're the person that knows that, tell the group or tell those people, hey, this will be helpful to you to do that. And just be assume, you know, their best intentions of trying to help you move it along so you have more fun. So I guess we'll just cover just putting etiquette, because it's something that I think people wonder about what to do. So in order, a lot of people like their balls marked. Some people don't like it, don't care if it's marked. I know Julie plays, she doesn't care if other people mark their balls, but then some, we may play with one person group who does. So it's a good idea just to walk up to your golf ball on the green. You can use a penny, a quarter, or a lot of people have a marker on their glove or hat already. Put a mark down, grab your ball. If you want to clean it, you can then. But it's just a good habit to get into. And why? Because you may go play golf with at some tournament or some league or something else, and you're playing with some person who, that's a really big thing to them. They don't want to see a golf ball out of the corner of their eye sitting there. Then you did it. You have it covered. Even if it does, even if it's something that doesn't bother you at all. Like, it doesn't bother me, I don't care about it either. But some people are really care about those little things in golf. So it's easier just to, you just mark it. And when you're ready to go, then you put your ball back down, and that's the easiest thing. And I think, we'll get into some of the other stuff later, but I think the other thing is just ask questions. You can throw questions out in Facebook, but you also have me. So if there's any questions you have, ever, don't ever feel like you can't ask. You can send us emails. If I'm there at the time, Julie will pretty much always be there. I'll try to be there, but feel free to ask questions. That's what we're here for, is to help. And if you just wonder about something, should I do this? Don't ever be embarrassed about anything, because the goal is we want to help everybody here enjoy it, have fun, and hopefully get better at golf at the same time.
So on that note of questions, we'll open up for questions now. So what questions do you have about anything that we've discussed, or anything that you feel like has been left out that you're curious about? What can we answer for you? And you can put it in the chat. I'll go ahead and stop sharing my screen so we can see faces and you can see where we're at. But you can put it in the chat if you have a question. You can raise your hand. You can use the raise hand feature. Yeah, Jam.
Hi. My question is, in the future, are we thinking about playing other courses other than McCormick Ranch? You seem to be saying that Duos League might be doing it at various courses. So if we're not in a duo, but we would like to try to play other courses, is that something the league is looking to do?
Yeah, so I think we're looking at ways to allow, since everybody is a member of the Duos League, maybe somebody who doesn't necessarily have a partner, that you can connect with other members of the league to come and experience that. It takes a bit more planning to work with other leagues, because you're dealing with different prices, availability, like different cutoffs for deadlines and that type of a thing. So that's going to take a little more organization, but we want to allow for people who don't have a partner to be able to connect with other members of the league, to be able to experience that and play at other courses.
Oh, okay. That'd be great.
Yeah.
And I'm back.
Julie, are they allowed to bring somebody with that, or can you invite a friend to do the duos league, or how does that work?
Yeah. Yeah. So for the duos, the registration works where you need to fill out your name and then the guest name. So if you do have a guest and it's not something that it's always the same person, that's totally fine. You just add your guest who's going to come, and you pay for the two of you, and then you would be paired together. So yeah, so we'll facilitate within the group. You'll be able to use the Facebook group to find people, and we'll kind of work that out. This is a little bit of an experiment, but an experiment that I'm excited about for the opportunity.
Julie, there are a few questions. Yeah. The cost for the league, is there a cost for the league and besides the green fees?
Sure, yeah. So there is a cost for the league. So there's a cost of $199 for the year. That's the league only, or you can pay $299, which includes a lesson with Eric. And Eric's lessons are $250 an hour. So really that's like a lesson plus $49 gets you into the league. So Those are the two options, the two membership options that you have. And then Maggie's question about handicaps.
Yeah.
I would say most players, were you going to say something?
Yeah, I was going to answer. You go ahead.
Okay. So most players, I don't think have handicaps, or if they do, they don't utilize them. So we offer two flights, and I'll explain what flights are. So flights are different groups of people that typically are based on handicaps. So in a tournament, you'll have different flights that are according to handicap. And so we offer two flights, one for people who do have handicaps and want to keep score, and then one flight for people who want to use it as a practice round and or don't have a handicap because they haven't been playing enough to start doing that. So yeah, I'll ask Maggie.
Go ahead. I was just going to try to answer some of these. Yeah, Maggie.
If that answered Maggie's question.
Yes, that's great. Thank you.
Okay.
Okay, so as far as about posting handicap, yes, you can post your handicap anytime you play it as, you know, your own ball. So, yes, you're welcome to post it for your handicap. Our times, I believe, are start at 3 o'clock and 3:30, depending on the time of the year. Is that right, Julie?
Right. So the league, like in terms of dates, like our first event is going to be the 1st of October. So this coming Sunday. So the deadline for
3:30 tee time or 3 o'clock?
It'll be a 3:30 tee time. And
then we have to go
through
to 3
October.
O'clock. Yeah.
Through October, it's 3:30 and then it'll adjust to 3 o'clock because it starts getting darker earlier. I'm like, how does that work out?
And then the duo is 18 holes. Correct?
Right. Yeah. We're planning on duos being 18 holes. Yeah. Registration.
So the time for duos is 1 o'clock or 1:04. I think the first one starts at, is that right? On a Saturday?
That's what we're needing to finalize. We haven't been able to connect on that. So I think that sounds about right. I will be sending out registration information for those of you who aren't members yet that has like detailed instructions with screenshots about how to register for the league. So if you run into any issues or have any questions about that, feel free to reach out to me and I can help you through it. But that should, the PDF forms that I have typically are good enough to help most people get through the registration process for the league. How many members are in the league? It's always kind of a rotating number because different people have signed up at different points along the way, and your membership lasts for a year from the date that you sign up. And so it's something that I think right now we have around 60, but I haven't looked recently to see exact numbers, but I feel like it's a good number and I hope that it continues to grow. So we just have more people that are able to come and participate in each event. So tee times, 18 holes. Okay. Seeing what other questions. Days of the week that we play, Maggie, Sundays and Wednesdays for the women's league. And we're looking at Saturdays for the duos league. And does this league allow us to maintain a USGA gin? Yes, Kristen, if you are wanting to keep track of your score, there is a way to include 9-hole rounds for gin. Eric can talk more to that.
Yeah, if you're asking if the league maintains it, we don't. You would have to post it wherever you'd normally post. But if that's what, I don't know if that's how you're asking that question, but.
Okay. Can I talk then?
Yeah. Ask your question.
Well, like I'm currently a member at McCormick and I have to have a membership somewhere is my understanding in order to like, cause I use the gin app to maintain my handicap, but my membership expires at the end of October. So I'm trying to understand if I were to like join your league, is that something where I still maintain that? Like, is this considered like having a membership at a course or
no, you would have to still maintain it with McCormick if that's, you would have to maintain it with them, not with us, because that's what they're doing. there's also other ways you can actually do it now where you don't have to be at, they've changed it over the last couple of years. So I would look into how you do it without, I think you can even not, so you have to pay a fee now at a course, typically what, like $40 or something for them to do it. Is that what they charge at McCormick or something?
Well, I don't know. I mean, I paid a couple thousand dollars to have the membership this past year. So it was okay, included
yeah,
in that.
Well, yeah. Yeah. So, but there's other ways I would look on. I can actually, I can send you a couple of ways to do it that you don't even have to, if you're not a membership there anymore, have it go through a club. So they've actually made it easier on people so they don't have to be part of something to do it. You can register through, there's a couple of different apps. So I can post that in the group, either tonight or tomorrow, of a couple of different ways you can do it without being okay. a member of something, of course. Yep.
Okay.
So I do want Amy, your hand is raised. We'll come back to the questions in the chat. What question do you have, Amy?
I just, what's the best way? Because I seem to always, I know you have the deadline. How I often will realize, oh goodness, I should check if there's golf this Sunday. what's the best way that you guys announce it or to sign up? And now I know, obviously, I'll know that I need to do it 3 days ahead for sure. But yeah, what's the best way to go about signing up for a day to golf?
Sure. So the days should be listed out there on our website. So they all, so just finding the right day that you're wanting to sign up for. I do send out an email to all members, and I send or I post in the Facebook group typically 4 or 5 days before. So just a day or two before the deadline to say, here's a reminder, the deadline's tomorrow. So make sure that you sign up. But if you aren't necessarily checking your email and you miss it, then yeah, just know that the dates are all listed on our website. Like on
know the that website. I have your website.
Okay. Yeah. So the website, yeah, let me type it in.
I'm bad at email, and I don't typically check Facebook. So I
right.
Well,
yeah.
The good thing is you'll find the whole season, every date listed already on that address.
That's perfect. Perfect.
So the dates are all there, and they're ready to register on the registration page. So, yeah.
Yeah, and there, Kristen, there's one that Lee put in. Thank you, Lee, that just through the Arizona Golf Association, you can do it without being a member anywhere for $40.
Yeah. Great. Thank
you. So thanks, Lee. Yeah,
thanks, Lee. Maggie asks, how many women play weekly on average? It really, really varies. So this past winter was a wet, cold, rainy winter. And so there were times that there were two of us that played in particular events. And then there's times that there's been, I think, 24, 26. So it really varies widely depending upon what people's schedules are. We don't have any type of minimum of the number of rounds that you have to play as a member of the league. So with that flexibility comes a wide range of the number of people that play.
And I think the day there were two players, those were the only two on the course. That's all bad it was. just give you
an
idea.
And I was one of them. And
not pretty conditions.
It was a really, really fast round. Yeah.
some troopers.
So then Kristen asked about playing other courses beside McCormick. Right now for the Women's League, we just have rounds scheduled with McCormick, with the Duos League that we have that you get as a member of the Women's League. We will be offering one event every month that we'll be playing at different courses. We are going to start that one at McCormick just because it's in October, which is when places are overseeding. And McCormick has two courses, and they have said, unless it rains, like the day before or the day of, we should be able to like drive on the course, whereas most other places are going to be cart path only. So we were like, well, let's start at McCormick. We know it's the same course, but it is something that we are going to be playing at other courses. And we've already reached out to start getting pricing and getting dates and that type of a thing. Trying to see if there's anything else that I missed. the cost for each round. So the cost for the nine hole rounds at McCormick are going to be $69. For those of you who have been members, that is higher. It was $60 before, and the courses raised their rates like everything else in America. So it's going to be $69 per round at this point. Any other questions that I missed? And I see another one popped up in the chat, but just want to see if, okay, I think I've captured them all. So your spouse won't pay anything for the membership for duos. So partner or whatever, like you just bring somebody as a guest, you'll just pay for their round. So you'll be paying for two rounds instead of one. So two memberships for one. Wasn't that a commercial or something? Or maybe it's the count on like two memberships. Okay. Any other questions? Correct. $69 is for the nine hole rounds. Yeah, Mary. Or Jen, I mean, sorry.
That's okay. Hi. Since I'm sort of out of commission here till the first of the year, if by any chance you're having a dinner or cocktails after a game, after a round, can I join if I am able to?
Sure.
Physically like I'll, get there?
Yeah, when I send out the email about like the reminder of deadlines, if you just want to respond and let me know you won't be playing, but you're interested in the dinner drinks afterwards. Yeah, that's right. Fine. We can do that. We can add you to the list.
Okay. At least in October, November and December, I'll be out for sure.
But yeah. Dealing with your shoulder.
Yeah.
Best of luck.
Okay. Thank you. Yeah. You I'm going to miss it.
Yeah. We'll miss having you. Jan's a fun one to play with, so we look forward to her coming back.
Yeah.
Oh, thanks, Mary. Mary's another gem of a member. All of our members are gems. Yep. So thanks, Mary. We try our best. And if there is anything that you feel like is missing, like give us feedback that really is helpful for us to know what's going well and what you could see as improvement. Sometimes our hands are tied with certain things that the course allows us or does not allow us to do. But we take things under advisement and see what we can do to make adjustments as necessary. So anything else, any other questions?
Oh, here's a question. How long does the season kind of run? Obviously starts October. Does it go through May or April? Or
typically it goes until about the middle of May. Right now we have dates up through April. I kind of, the first year, everybody was like, yeah, we'll play through the summer. And then it got about halfway through May. And no, that didn't happen. So we were like, okay, we took the summer off and like started again in October. And then this last year, I was like, okay, let's kind of see what happens. We were able to work with the course to shift from afternoons to mornings on Wednesdays. So through the summer, we offered Wednesday tea times at 7 o'clock in the morning. And some people played, nine holes. Some people had the ability to play 18. And because June was cool, it really wasn't too bad. And even into July, nine holes, we were done early enough that I was like, all right, we're getting off the course before it's like 105, which was fine. And so I feel like we'll probably do something similar. We'll just have to kind of see as we get into May. I kind of want to see how weather is before we commit to specific times, but we'll just make adjustments depending upon where temperatures land in May and make that adjustment to our summer season. So Kristen, deadline for joining their league or joining the league. So I would say join as soon as you can. So taking advantage of as much of the time as possible. So with our first event being on Sunday, the deadline to sign up is going to be, I have to do math. Is it Thursday? Is it tomorrow? Today's Wednesday. Anyway, yeah, so Thursday. So with the information that I send out, like if you're wanting to join us on Sunday, you need to register for, if you aren't a member of the league, and then also register by midnight tomorrow night to be able to play that Sunday. So the registration is ongoing. It's not as if we ever like, no, we don't want more members to join, but I just feel like there's not really a reason to put it off unless you're not in the area so that you can start taking advantage of events. We haven't started any tournaments against other women's leagues. That's an interesting idea. So I know that there aren't a whole lot of other women's leagues, especially that do 9 holes, and not to say that we couldn't do a tournament that's 18 holes, but I'm going to write that down as something to look into. Any other questions? Okay. All right. Well, if you do think of anything, please reach out. Like I said, I will send out information to those of you who are not members yet, with the information of how to register. Feel free to ask me any questions that you have regarding that. And for those who are members, I'll be sending out a reminder that we have a registration deadline tomorrow. And just excited to see all of the people who will be there on the first and beyond. We're excited to get a new season going and have new people join us and just make the circle that much bigger. So thanks everybody for your time, and we will see you soon.
Thank you. Bye.
Bye everybody.